It is another busy week for the Space Coast. Boeing, SpaceX, and Blue Origin are all making news.
West 2 Sheldon Dutez lays out the plan for Starliner, what's next for the Polaris Dawn, and the new rocket expected to blast off soon.
That's the sound that Commander Butch Wilmore heard inside the Starliner spacecraft. The audio was recorded and uploaded to NASASpaceflight.com.
It's a strange noise coming through the speaker. I don't know what's making it.
Yep, good recording. Thanks, Butch. We will pass it on to the team and let you know what we find.
The pulsing noise turned out to be audio feedback. NASA sent WESH 2 a statement saying, "The feedback from the speaker was the result of an audio configuration between the space station and Starliner. The speaker feedback has no technical impact to the crew." Starliner will fly to the New Mexico desert this Friday, empty. NASA determined the unknowns with the thruster malfunctions and helium leaks are too great a risk for Commander Butch Wilmore and pilot Sonny Williams. The plan is for the Crew 9 to fly up to the ISS with two on board, with Butch and Sonny remaining at the space station until February with Crew 9. Back on Earth, the crew of Polaris Dawn is waiting for their chance to perform the world's first all-commercial spacewalk. Commander Jared Isaacman posted on X that the crew participated in formation flying while in quarantine. Polaris Dawn was scrubbed because of offshore weather. Florida Tech professor Don Platt explains why that weather plays a big role in human spaceflight launches.
So they do not want to have to be sitting out there, you know, for extended periods of time, hours, or even up to maybe a day. If they had to make a landing that was far away from where the ground ships and ground capabilities were.
Finally, Blue Origin is rolling out the second stage of the new Glenn rocket out to Launch Complex 36. Ars Technica is reporting a hot fire test of the upper stage will happen in the coming days, a big step closer to becoming a competitor with SpaceX. The new Glenn has a lift capacity of roughly 45 tons to low Earth orbit. Sheldon Dutez, WESH 2 News.
And WESH 2 will have live team coverage of the Polaris Dawn mission. FAA records show the launch is expected to happen early Wednesday morning with a backup day on Thursday.